Don, by myself, Manuel Mergoza and Luis Gómez Robledo from University of Granada, Alain Tremont from University Saint-Étienne in France, and Guya Kui and Ronnie Luo from University of Leeds in UK. These are the contents of my presentation, an introduction, goal, experimental method, and the results and conclusion. This communication is in the same framework that the one I have yesterday. In the framework of the Technical Committee 155 about uniform color space for industrial color difference evaluation, we are testing different color difference equation with new experimental data. Yesterday, it seemed that DIN 99D is a very good formula, but it is, but is not the best always. The state of the art in this field now, in this technical committee, is that different experimental data, we have different results with the different experimental data. One formula can be the best for one data set, and another different for another data set we are going to see today. Then there are many recent color difference equations from the publication of Delta E 2000. We are going to take into account Delta E 2000, and also these new formulas can O2 fit for a small color difference, can O2 fit for uniform color space for all differences, small and large. Also DIN 99D, and the formulas OSA GP and OSA Euclidean GP. Also, I am going to consider CLF, CA94, and CNC as historical formulas for comparison. Some of the former formulas have been tested and developed using the same experimental data set, the CON data set. This combined data set is formed by four subsets: the BFD, LIT, RIT DuPont, and BIT. Then it's necessary to have new experimental data set to check, to test the formulas. But also new experimental data had been required by Technical Committee 155, the number of currently available data is limited. On the other hand, we can consider the range of validity of the formulas. There is another technical committee in the CAE 163 to study the validity of the range of Delta E 2000. At first, Delta E 2000 and CAE 194 were recommended in the range from 0 to 5 CLF unit. We have previous studies indicating that most formulas perform quite badly in the very small color difference range of about 1 CLF unit. Also, a study of the color pair in the COM dataset indicates that the small color differences are overestimated. Therefore, it seems convenient to study the performance of color difference formulas, especially for small color differences, which are of great interest in many applications. To achieve this goal, a new experimental data set had been used. The data set is formed by very small color differences in the range 0.14 to 2.14 CLF unit. And to check the performance of the formulas, the weighted normalized strength index has been employed. The experimental data was obtained in two different experiments carried out in the laboratory Haber-Curien of Saint-Étienne in France, called Experiment R and experiment B. In experiment R, real surface metallic samples were observed in a very bright light boot under D65. Observation of 0 degrees. In this way, the observer were perpendicularly to the sample to avoid glosses, and the two samples were compared side by side. This geometry followed the ISO standard 3668-2003. With this methodology, five different color centers were studied. In experiment B, virtual samples were displayed in a LCD monitor in dark viewing condition. The size of the patches displayed was identical to the size of the real sample. The LCD was calibrated with a Greta Mattbeck I1 Pro colorimeter, and then the color displayed were measured by a Minorta telespectral radiometer. The average uncertainty was around 0.46 CLF unit, and the average accuracy of the color differences between pairs were lower than 0.2 CLF unit. We can consider that the relative accuracy of the LCD screen didn't affect the observer judgment. With this methodology, the same five centers plus 11 additional were studied. Here we have the CLF coordinate of the 16 color center, also the number of pairs and number of observers for each center. Red background indicate common center in experiment R and B. The name of the color center comes from the RAR color chart. The numbers of pairs after slash correspond to experiment R, before slash to experiment B. In bracket, we have the final number of use of the employed pairs. We will see later. Note that some centers have the same names but are denoted with A or B. As can be observed in the table, these centers have close color coordinate but not exactly the same. In this figure, we can see the 16 center located in the CLF space. Also, the projection, the center have CLF coordinates in the range 8 to 90 for likeness, 1.5 to 65 for chroma, and 34 to 260 degrees for hue angles. Different number of samples were considered in each center, differing in likeness, chroma, hue, or combination of them. The color difference ranged from 0.14 to 2.14 CLF unit in experiment R, and from 0.20 to 2.12 CLF unit in experiment B. Combining the two experiments, the data set consists of 390 color pairs arranged around the 16 color center. The 26 observers participate in experiment R, and approximately 14 observers participate in experiment B. 7% women, 93% men, age from 24 to 45, all with normal color vision. In total, 7,524 estimations were performed. Here we have the observer for each center. Remember that the number of pairs after slash correspond to experiment R. We have the pair used for each center. Approximately were considered 26 pair of samples per color center in experiment B and 10 in experiment B. The task to the observer were to estimate and score the global color difference in each pair as non-noticeable, score 0, just noticeable, score 1, or noticeable, score 2. Identical instructions were given to observers in experiments R and B, performed in independent sessions. Observers were instructed to face directly the sample in order to avoid the change of color with viewing angle, typical in LCD monitor. The weighted normalized stress had been used to compute the performance of the different color different equation. The stress runs between 0 and 100 in such a way that greater values means worse agreement between visual and computed color differences. This index allows a statistical inference through the F-test. In the formula, delta E is the computed color difference, delta B is the visual difference estimated by the observers. In this quote, this delta B is taken equal to 1, because for all cases it is the just noticeable color difference. We are interested in only just noticeable color difference, not the other two cases. And we can fit this value as 1, because stress is invariant through F1 to multiplying delta B or delta E by a factor. The weighting factor is the weighting factor for each color different pair I, where S1 is the number of estimation with score 1, just noticeable difference. And TNS is the total number of estimation for this pair. In this way, the variability between observers is taken into account through this weighting factor. In this way, to work out the stress, the weighted stress, we use all color pairs, except the one with a weighting factor equal to 0, which means that not any observer has estimated the color difference as just noticeable, or equivalently, that all observers agree that the color difference is either non-noticeable, score 0 for all, or more than just noticeable, score 2 in all observers. The table shows in bracket the number of pair after removing the pair with weighting factor equal to 0. This is because we have number of pair and also in bracket the number of pairs used. The third column show weighted. Here we can compute also the weighted mean color difference with the formula using the same weighting factor. In third column, we have this weighted means color difference in CLAP unit for all center. Values after a last correspond to experiment R, as before. It can be noted that almost all values are below one CLAP unit, which had been considered approximately as the just perceptible color difference. Also can be noted similar values in the result of experiment R and B. We can analyze a posteriori the good election of the sample around each pair, seeing the histogram of the weighting factor. The optimal design will correspond to weighting factor varying from 0 to 1, with most cases around 0.5, which correspond to 50% of observers estimating the color difference as just noticeable. More cases close to 0 than 1 are expected, because weighting factor 0 groups the extreme two types of color difference, non-noticeable or for all observers, or more than just noticeable for all observers. On the other hand, weighting factor 1 corresponds to a just noticeable difference, score 1, for all observers, which is very difficult to reach. From figure, it will be concluded a poor choice of sample for center 10-15A, which will be considered in future measurements in this center. Here we have the histogram for experiment R and experiment B with the same 5 color center. The rest of the 11 color center for experiment B here is the Easter one. Besides, few color centers have color differences with weighting factor higher than 0.6. This means high variability between the observer estimating the just noticeable differences. In the result, here we have the weighted stress for all the formulas and the two experiments. Also, the value for the COM data is shown to compare. The second row shows the total number of pairs in each data set and in bracket the number of pairs after removing the pairs with weighting factor equal to 0. It can be noted that all formulas perform better in experiment B than R. The reason could be the different number of both centers and pairs between experiment R and B. A small number of pairs in experiment R would lead to a deficient evaluation of the statistical index stress. For a more meaningful comparison between experiment R and B, a reduced set of experiment B has been considered, containing only the same 5 center of experiment R, but with different number of pairs. The stress values computed in this subset are now very close to the values for experiment R. Also, the global set has been considered, with close values to experiment B, with much higher number of pairs than experiment R. It can be seen that our formula, except CLAB, performed worse in both experiments R and B than in COM data. However, considering the range 0 to 1 CLAB unit in the COM data, similar values of stress have been reported. Therefore, the range of color differences is a critical question in the performance of color difference formulas. Thus, additional research will be desirable to adjust the color difference formulas in this small color difference range. Red circle indicates the best results in each dataset. In our dataset, CLAB obtained the best result, followed by CAN02 uniform color space. It is surprising that CAN02 UCS obtained better result than CAN02 SCD, because CAN02 SCD is fit for a small color difference, but with different data. But it's interesting to see the statistical significance of the differences between formulas from these values of F-test. Here, this table shows the F-test results for experiments R of the first 10 rows and B, the last rows. Please, don't worry about the number, but about colors. Green means that the formula in the row is better than the one in the column. On the contrary, red means that the formula in the row is worse than the one in the column. Like, color means a statistically insignificant difference, and dark color means a statistically significant difference. Surprisingly, CLAB is either better or significantly better than any other formula for this data. Among the other, CAN02 UCS performs quite better than the rest, and also CAE19-4 only in experiment B. Delta-E2000 is the formula performing worse in general, except in experiment B, where CNC is the worst. In conclusion, all the analysis recent color different formulas perform quite badly in the specific region of just noticeable color differences. Agreeing with former studies realized in the context of the Technical Committee 163, it seems that the most recent color different formula, which outperformed CLA in most of the data set are not well fitted to this particular color difference magnitude. This result encouraged the research about the validity of color difference formulas in the range 0 to 1 CLAP unit, and the subsequent fit of the formulas in this region. Thank you for your attention.
So thank you for your presentation. Maybe we have time for just one question. No questions at all, so we... Yes.
I was interested in the possibility of including pairs in which there is zero difference.
Including pairs with a score zero?
Not with a score, but with a physical difference of zero, so that you could compute a D prime measure instead. Has this been done?
Sorry, the question is to include pairs with no color difference between them, and to see the answer of the server to this case.
So you could compute a false alarm rate?
Not, we have not considered this case.
But this would allow you to compute a bias-free measure of performance, and in principle obtain something more robust, which would be nice.
Yes, thank you.
I can tell the opposite. You do the sum for observability. I think that the observability is in this case is much more bigger problem, because I would predict that this physical zero pair for some observers will have subjective difference, right? And might actually guess that the more observers you take, the bigger bias will be, because they, on average, they will actually be biased in in different directions. And it's not actually clear that the average deviation will be somewhere between two points, right?
Yes, the inter-observer variability is very important. In this world is taken into account by the weighting factor, because different observer give different score, different answer, and then you weight this delta V with the weighting factor. The most observer giving the same answer, the most weight you give to this.
How can you count what you don't know? You don't know in which direction each individual observer deviate from the standard CIE observer?
Not.
No.
Not.
Okay, thank you again. And now your turn.